Now I'm focusing on what are the ethical aspects we have to follow during our research work. Because most of the research scholars are not aware of it, how we can go for the research. They're not following the correct ethical process for incorporating the research work. That is the biggest problem. The research side, even the PhD scholars not doing the research in a perfect ethical way. That is why in our syllabus, we are incorporating the topic is ethical consideration of quantity and qualitative research. Here I am focusing on the two kinds of research. One is called quantitative as well as qualitative. That I may give you some kind of input about the two different things. First, I may talking about what is the need for the ethical consideration, what is need for the research ethics while doing a research. Actually, the research ethics provides guidelines for the responsible conduct of the research. In addition, it educates and monitors scientists or the researchers to conduct research to ensure a high ethical standard. The problem with the people, those who want to do the research, no, they may join the research. But after this, they could not go for the research in a proper ethical way. Some people are cooking the data and they are publishing the article, and or even there some of the people are just doing the cut and copy techniques and they publish the previous report also. This is the way some of the things is going on. That is why all the researchers should know what are the research practices or research ethics we have to follow while doing a research. That is the main intention. They incorporate this kind of topic in for your MET, even for the PhD course or for this kind of topic. Yes. See, the first I'm moving to the quantitative research. Normally, in the education side, we can divide the research into two ways. One is called quantitative research, then second one is called qualitative research. If you are mixing the both, then it's called as a mixed research. There is a term in our education side we are using. If you are adopting the quantitative research partially as well as the qualitative research partially while doing your research, we may use the term as a mixed research. It means that you are blending the two research in a single research work. So that kind of work is called as a mixed research. Even for doing a research of mixed research or quantitative research or qualitative research, as a researcher, you have to follow strictly on the research ethics. First, I may define what is the quantitative research. Normally, the quantitative research involves studies in which the data that are analyzed are in the form of numbers. So what if the numbers in the sense, while doing a quantitative research, if you want to do any analyze, we can depend on the number. But in the context of qualitative, there is no numbers and all. Based on observations, based on the interview, based on the qualitative information from the participants, you are doing some kind of analysis work. Even some of the softwares may supporting the quantitative research. Similarly, some of the softwares may supporting the qualitative research also. Even the qualitative research, the approach normally the behaviors are counted, or correct answers or errors are counted, and other types of measures are recorded in terms of quantity. So, for example, I am doing a research. How much people are affected by the COVID? So if you want to do some kind of research, what are the symptoms they're facing? Either I'm doing the research in this, I can go directly to the field, I can observe it, I can give some kind of report. But the report may be in the counted form, number of people are affected, number of people are dead, that kind of counting. But see, the daily there is a report from the Kerala government as well as the Tamil Nadu government, the entire India government also giving the picture about the number representation or number based the COVID attacked per day. So sometimes some of the states is not following properly in the sense they may give some kind of random number. It's not correctly exactly the conducted or they find the how many people are affected. Sometimes there is some mistakes may be happened. That's why they given the wrong kind of information to this, but it's not be fair. The same thing while doing a research also. As a researcher, we have to pinpoint the correct findings in a number-based, in a quantity-based. Then, the quantitative research involves both experimental and non-experimental research. Particularly in the context of the experimental research, the focus on protecting the individuals to receive an intervention. Intervention is a treatment. Even suppose, as a researcher, I want to do the research in the effectiveness of multimedia package and enhance mathematics achievement. But while I'm talking about the multimedia package, but my package is talking about only the the two-dimensional, only the audio-based insect is not be fair. So our intervention should be accurate. As well as from the intervention, we have to find out in what manner the action is producing after the interventions. Like that, we have to track check with this kind of quantitative data. And the same way, there is a non-experimental research like a survey type. Suppose you want to know what is the impact of this kind of virtual teaching to the student side. So whether the students are liking or disliking this kind of virtual learning, for that you want to do some kind of research, you can go with some kind of survey techniques. That is may come under the non-experimental research. I hope now you understand the exact meaning of quantitative research. Quantity means if you are doing the research, but the research survey, or if you want to do analyze of your research, you can depends on the number-based data. So it means that if you are having some kind of magnitude representation data, from the data you are doing analyze, then it's called as a quantity research. But there is another research is called qualitative research. Normally the qualitative research involves data that are recorded in a narrative description, not in a numbers base. So you could not find any numbers. For example, I want to observe some kind of religious people, how they are working, in what manner they are helping to the society. Like that, I want to observe some religious group or one cultural group. I can go and observe them in a participatory or non-participatory manner. I can observe and I'm giving the report in a qualitative manner. Here, there is no data at all. So the data may be in a qualitative nature, in a narrative description they may give. I am not dependent on the any kind of number-based things. So if you are analyzing the things based on the qualitative manner, the descriptive manner, the description manner, narrative description manner, then it's called as a qualitative research. The best example, suppose you want to do the, for book textbook analysis. So there is a Kerala government is publishing new textbooks of the 10th standard, 9th standard. If you want to analyze the positive and negatives of the textbook, you can go for qualitative research, because for that kind of observations for doing the textbook analysis, no need for the number based any kind of data is needed. Only the based on the content, based on the decoration, how they add the colorful images, whether they are adding the proper content in sequence. From this, we are analyzing. We are giving the report on. So that is called as a qualitative research. In the research approach, ethical qualitative research, the researcher use a qualitative method, normally like observations or discrete conditions rather than they control them. The basic ethical principles of qualitative research in this, don't tamper with the natural setting and district. Here, we could not be manipulated anything, so we can give the freedom to the participants. From after this, we have to be observed. For example, you are going for the intensive teaching practice. Suppose while I'm coming and sitting in your classrooms, you may feel fear, or you may having some kind of disturbance while I'm sitting in the class, because I'm going to observe you. If I sit the class, your presentation style is to be different. But if I not sit the class, but I am observing the class, your class from the outside of your classroom, your way of teaching is to be different. The same time, I'm not telling that I'm observing. Without knowing you, I'm observing your classes in a different mode, like a video camera, in different mode I'm observing. That time, your way of teaching is to be different. So it means that for the qualitative research, we have to ensure our participation of the researcher and the researcher. We could not be make it any kind of disturbance of the natural settings of the participant side. But normally, if the researcher observing in a participating mode, we could not be finding the exact result from the participant side. Sometimes due to the fear, due to the panic, they could not be show the exact talents, the entire things to the observers. So that is the biggest from the qualitative research. Now I'm moving to the main content of my today's presentation, research ethics. Even if you can go for qualitative research or quantitative research, we are in even mixed research also, we have to strictly follow this much of the research ethics. Things. One is called accuracy. The data should be accuracy in nature. Don't cook. Some people, sir, they're not going for data collections, but while asking them to submit thesis, they may submit the next week. So it means that they could be information, or they add the information as they like. They're not going for the field, they're not collecting the data properly without going for data collections. They are putting the information, putting the data and give to us a report. That kind of things also some things are doing. That's why we have to strictly follow the accuracy of the data which you given to the during the recession. The credibility, credibility represents some of the people not think the giving the proper citation reference. Credibility in the sense, suppose you are using someone's message, someone's idea, you can give some acknowledgement for them. You can give the proper citation or acknowledgement, otherwise it's not be fair. Some people's telling that this year things founded by myself, like that they are proudly tell, but it's not be fair. So kindly tell who's normally in the case of education side, 1 + 1 = 3. In the context of the mathematics may be wrong, but in the context of the education side, 1 + 1 = 3. It means what? One idea of mine, one idea of yours. So we are mixing the two ideas, my idea plus your idea. Then we can generate the third idea. That is called mixing up. So the same manner, suppose you are developing a new innovative idea, that is not purely your innovation. You are depends on some of the ideas of others. Then yours idea, you are merging and finally you are producing the new idea. So, but you have to give the acknowledgement or the citations. We have to properly give thanks the particular person's ideas which you use for your research. That is called credibility. Then confidence. Sometimes you are doing some kind of human-based survey. Suppose you are doing a research for the jail. So you are doing the some research in the Kannur jail and all. That time you may have in the discussion with some people, those are in the jail. But during the discussion, you are the researcher, you are getting some information about the theft, about the murder, what they did. So, but that information don't share to anyone. So whenever you're collecting the data from the participants, don't share the information to others without the consent of the particular participant. Normally the research, we are giving the report, but the report is not pinpointed to each individual of our participants or the sample. We are giving this generalized report only. We are not pinpointed this person's stayed for 7 years in the jail, he did this much of problems. We are not describing that kind of, because it's like a confidential things. He is sharing the confidential to, in the sense, as a researcher, you have to keep the confidential in a proper manner. Otherwise, it's not a research. The next is a transparency. So there is a mismatch with the confidence and transparency. What is the confidence and transparency? In the case of the participants' data, you don't be give to others. But in the context of the transparency, in the sense, suppose I am the researcher, I am developing a new tool. Someone's asking, some Sufair asking, sir, I need your data, I need your tool for doing my research. So you can open-mindedly, you can give the tools to me. Because I already did the research, I develop one package or I develop one kind of questionnaire. This questionnaire, if once someone's need for adopting his for his research work, instead of hiding your research work in the library or in your bureau, you can give to them. Because normally the main intention of the research, it may be reach the society. If you are doing the research, but the research work you are keeping in your bureau itself, what is the need to the work of your research? That PhD work or any kind of research work, the research work output, it may reach the society. Then when it is the same way, once you finish the research work, someone's asking to you, sir, can I use your research? Or can I use your data? Sorry, not the data. Can I use your tool for my research work? In the sense, you can open-mindedly, you can allow them. Even some people, sir, criticizing your work, you can accept it, because some we cannot be go for 100% perfect. Once you keep your dissertations or your research work to open only, that you can know what kind of mistakes you did. Otherwise, if you keep it in the library, you could not know whether you did the research work in correct manner or wrong. Once you get the some kind of negative comments only, we can enrich our work. So that kind of transparency we need. Apparently, we have to keep the honesty. Honesty in the sense, for in what manner you are doing the research work in an integrative manner. Suppose you are collecting one data, but while writing in the research report, you are giving the other. For example, I am supporting one party, one government party, but I am collecting the data from different party. The different parties criticize my like party. Then immediately, what they, while I writing the research report, I may put the information of the previous party, what they tell the wrong about my party. I may totally hide the information and write the positive sides of the my party. that kind of things don't do. Suppose if one person is criticizing something in the sense, you have to pinpoint and don't highlight the names of the person. Just you can give us a honest report or honest survey things to be present. Then sometime we can be protect the participants' details. That's why I use the terms confidential. Authenticity in the sense, whenever you are highlighting any information, it should be authentic, like true information. Don't use false or wrong information to write the research report. Then the main thing, originality, don't do a cut and copy work. At least you can, if you're writing 100 pages, at least one or two pages from your own idea. You can go with 90 pages, that's not an issue. At least one or two pages, you can think and you can give your own idea in it. Just instead of, don't go for cut and copy. And then finally, we can go with plagiarism. Plagiarism is nothing but copying the other's work, and you are claiming that is my article or this is my work. Suppose Sufair is writing, or Musambi is writing one book. So without knowingly, I am stolen this book. I remove the first page of them. I write my name and publish the other books. For example, he published in Kerala one publication. I am going for Tamil Nadu with other publication and publish. This is called plagiarism. You are adapting, you are doing some kind of wrong practices. You are claiming that it is my work instead of the other work. That is called plagiarism. These are the research ethics we have to follow strictly while doing research. We can discuss one by one. The first one is accuracy. Accuracy is immoral to misrepresent the data or skew things towards a particular finding. There is no value in such research, and this literally undermines the whole purpose of the conducted research. It is our responsibility as a researcher to produce valid and accurate results also. This especially the case where our research involves people, as it would be apparent to misrepresent them, their viewpoints or opinions. Suppose you are giving some kind of misleading information, but that your research work is, the people are keeping the library. After reading that, they may give you a different meaning if you are giving some wrong information in the research work. Therefore, avoid careless errors and negligence. For example, instead of 100, while typing, you are putting, say, 1,000. There's a difference between 100 and 1,000. You are thinking only 10 is the number, only there's a mistake. No? Don't think like this, because 10 is making a very big impact in the research report. So it may be a careless error, but the 100, when you're typing as 1,000, the different meanings goes. Okay. For example, the Kerala, the COVID cases, I am putting as 101. So otherwise 1,001. When I'm writing in the WhatsApp group, I'm typing 1,001. But the case is 10,001. So if there is a very big difference between the 1,001 and 10,001. Yesterday it reached 10,000, no? So the same way that our information should be accurate in nature. Some people are writing like this in the research report. Some other people are affected by COVID in the Kasaragod or the Kannur or in the Kanjangad. So this is not correct. Some of them means, what is the exact number? Some means what? Some means maybe 1,000, some means 10 also some. File also some. Then what is that sum represent? Therefore, whenever you're writing a research report, don't use the word sum or field student. Instead of that, you have to pinpoint the numbers. Carefully and critically examine your research. What keep good records and activity? That is why I understood in what manner we have to keep the accuracy. While doing a data collection, while keeping the research design, while implementing the research design, then while sending the articles to the journals or publication, you can keep it everywhere as an accuracy. That's very much important. The next thing, credibility. What is the credibility? So the biggest problem, the people's, I'm using the other's idea, but while writing here, I'm not quoted, I'm not giving the thanks to particular people. That is why, while writing the assignment itself, we are asking to write in acknowledgements, not in an acknowledgement or a reference. What is the need for reference? You can know where you are referred. So you may refer 10 or 5 books, but in the end of your assignment, you are writing some reference. What is the need? At least we can ensure from where you are getting the information. But in the case of the research site, some of the people are not giving the proper citations or proper thanks to the content they go through from the different sources. That is why the credibility is much important. As a researcher, we have to give the proper citations where you are typing the informations, whose information you are using, then properly we can give the thanks also to the particular people. That is why the research work, if you look onto the PhD work by MRDA, the front, the preliminary, the part after the certificate, after the declaration, the first two, the third page, it may be acknowledgement page. The acknowledgement is much important for who are supporting the research work. You have to give some kind of justice for them. Instead of hiding the names and you are showing that only my work, only my guide is not helping to me. So that some people say, actually the guide may contribute to something, but the people may hiding the things, just they're focusing only the research sites. For they may not highlight the guide name or the HOD name or the other names of the reform. It's not fair. That's why the credibility is like a research ethics we have to follow strictly. The next thing is a confidential. In what manner the confidentials you can look on it? What is the represent of confidential? So here the confidential, often, particularly in the context of our education side, we are always collecting the sample from the student side or from the human side. Often, we can offer anonymity or confidentiality to our participants. In doing so, it's vital we handle the data carefully and sensitively. If the participant believes what they say is confidential, they may be more open. Suppose you are, I'm asking to the some schools, I'm doing some case study. The particular student's having a lot of issue in his family life as well as the some personal life. He's giving some kind of, I'm giving counseling for, as a counselor, as a researcher, I'm giving some counseling. But when I'm writing his report, otherwise some other the class teachers of the particular classrooms, they're approaching me. So what is the issue for him? Why he's not talking? Because why he's not reading properly? So what are things he shared? You don't share these things to the teachers, those are approaching. Because the participants, he believe a lot. The samples believe a lot. From this believeness, he is giving some kind of information to you. That information, it don't give in openly, those are approaching the sense. Instead of that, it can be compiled. So you can give a say, what is that, hiding manner you can give the information while writing the report. Don't be pinpoint a particular person. He having this much of issues, he fall in love with 10 girls, that's why it happened like this. Don't give these numbers. Instead of that, you can be rightly in a polite manner the research work. He's fall in love with girls, that is why this kind of things happen. Like that, you can write in a proper manner. Even some people are approaching directly to you, what is the problem for him? Don't tell the problems of the particular person, the person which he shared with. So that is totally to be unfair, because as a researcher, you should be a counselor. You like a counselor. So what are the problems you found from the participant side, or what are the things you are getting from the participant sample side? Don't be show, don't be share that information to others. That is why the confidential things is important. Apparently, protect the confidential community, such as papers, grants submitted. Here I may be focusing on the, while sending the paper or grants, we don't be highlighting the personal records. For example, there is a one problematic in the students. In my research report, I am highlighting the student's name, his age, his address, and what is the mistakes he committed during my classes. This is not a, we are not doing the research for particular persons. No? We are doing a research for generalized, but don't pinpoint the mistakes made by some of the participants. It's not fair also. And don't give the names, the report, the students, the participants, sample names, the reports. Even if you have, for example, I am working the research in the military secrets, I am collecting some information. But if someone's are asking this, and I won't be give that information. That's also be confidential. The same thing protecting, the same thing. Here the protections of the participants, respect the human dignity and privacy, because privacy is much important. In what context the privacy is need? In the sense, the right of an individual to control distributions of personal information. As a role of the thumb, there is a thumb rule, the researcher should invade the privacy of the participants as minimally as possible. As minimally as possible while writing the research report. Then when conducting research on human subjects, minimizing harms and risks to maximize the benefits. So be cautious while dealing the research work from the human side, but in the student side are the problems. The next ethics, transparency. What is the transparency? That's why I already mentioned. The transparency in the case of data, don't show the data, the participants things to others. Instead of that, the transparency of your work. Some people after did the entire work, they did lot of contribution, but the contribution may sleep in the cupboard itself. They won't share this contribution to the society. I already mentioned that research work, it's not for your research work, it is a society research work. So what are things you are doing, it may reach the society one. So what is the society? So your research work, it shows the it may impact the society. That is why we are doing the research in the what are the problems in the student side, what are the problems in the schools. We have to give some kind of remedy for that. But instead of that, we are hiding the research report without showing the others, not be fair. Here the share data, results and ideas and tools, this is be fair. But don't share the data of the individual participants. So for example, I'm collecting 1,000 participants data, but on that 1,000 participant data, I'm giving is a number based, not in a individual based. So this student's committed this much mistake, this student's committed this much. This is not like a single person's data I won't give. I am giving the 1,000 students report as a compilations in a number based. That's not an issue. That kind of openness. That is why some of the journals, the papers are publishing a quantity nature, like number representation. Even if you look onto the any kind of research article, you won't find the participant means like a sample. Sample's name, you won't found at anywhere. That kind of openness. Suppose if some people are asking, sir, can I use your research work? Can I use your dissertation for my reference? You can allow them instead of the hiding your research work in the bureau itself. So be open and kindly accept the criticism. Some people forgetting the criticism, they are not able to accept the criticism of your research work, their research work. That's why they won't show their research work to others. Some of the PhD scholars, so for example, some of the PhD people, they finish the PhD. If you're asking to show the PhD report, they won't show it because you may find out the mistakes. That mistake, they could not be accepted. So that is the biggest problem. The researcher side, they believe like this. It should not be fair. We have to open-minded to show our ideas and knowledge to others. Then honesty. What is the honesty represent the side of the student side, the particular researcher side? The honesty in this case is representing these sort of things. So honesty refers being accurate and truthful about oneself, one's work, and the work of others also. Researcher and research must contribute to the well-being of, as I already mentioned, the researcher as well the research report must contribute to the well-being of the society, not for your, but normally, if you look on deeply, the people are doing the research only for scientific purpose, not for the society. That is the biggest problem is going up. That is why I request the participants as students of MED, if you have the idea to do the PhD, kindly do the PhD for the society concern, not for your individual concern. Kindly provide such a wonderful, innovative ideas, the entry side to the, as a contribution from your side to the schools or the society. That is a good contribution. That is why most of the PhD scholars are doing the experimental method as a PhD, and they are selecting the experimental method. Because the experimental method, we can provide some kind of innovative ideas, innovative methods, innovative strategies, we can suggest to the schools or the education environment. That we have to look on it. But in the case of the MMR, we have the very limited time space. We cannot go for the experimental method. But in the context of the PhD level, if you want to do a PhD, kindly do a but is the society-based research work, but with the experimental method. Then researchers should be demonstrate honest and truthfulness. They should not be fabricate data, falsify results, or omit relevant data. They should report finding fully, minimize or eliminate bias in their methods, and disclose underlying the assumptions. Sometimes, you know, that's why I already mentioned, I am very much fond to one particular party or one kind of culture, one kind of religious group. But while writing a research report, I may focusing much about my religious group. So I tell that these groups are very good compared to the other group like that. I am misfaulting the information. Therefore, the researcher should be neutral. He is not slide to the one party to other religious party. That kind of thing, don't we keep it? Even if he has some kind of political background or some kind of religious background, that background things, it won't be disturb your research work. It should be neutral while doing your research work. That neutralness, it gives the value of your research work. That's why I'm suggesting to all of you, be cautious while doing the research work. That authenticity, in what manner the authenticity, the sense, the data should be authentic information you have to tell. Information should be authentic, proper setting. Some people say, yesterday also I heard some WhatsApp message. The biggest problem, the WhatsApp message. In the 2018, there is a newspaper cutting. It shows, it's highlighting that the message like this. UGC care list is not needed. Only the UGC refer list is accepted for the promotion. That is, information comes 2018. After this, lot of government change, lot of issues come. They used to give the different circular. But yesterday, the same 2018 message, it comes to the WhatsApp group. The people are so happy to see that because it's an old message. They think that it's here now. Yesterday only that information comes to the WhatsApp. Like that, they're thinking and misinterpreting the things. Therefore, whenever you are sharing anything, particularly the research work I'm telling, the research work you can share, even if you're writing any number. For example, in your classroom, there is a 50 students, 15 male and 14 students, 14 female. 15 male and 14 female. You can write correctly. Instead of some people are writing like this, there is a 50% of male, 50% of students are females are in the classrooms. It's not fair. You can give the authentic, correct information, accurate information. That information should be authentic, right? Then proper reference also you should give. The main thing is to be original. What is originality? That's I already mentioned. Whenever you are doing the work, kindly contribute at least from your own idea. Instead of the copying from someone's, it's not prepared. Some people, what they're doing, just doing the cut and copy. See this case, this much of umbrella is there. But what is the uniqueness you found from this umbrella? Only one person having the different color umbrella. So it may attracting this. The same thing, the innovations represent the originality of our work. Instead of following or instead of copying this other work, you have to find even that work, the innovation may be wrong. But the idea, we have to be appreciated, that idea which you created. The recently, the WhatsApp group, you may get some video related to one great teacher. I think he from the northern side. There, northern side, he knows that they're not having that much of network issues and network connection. That's why what the particular teachers did in the sense, he going to the students' group home, and he compiled near to the schools all the students. He made some boards for each students in his different spaces. For example, he find some wall. He painted the wall some in the different spaces with some social distances. He made some kind of blackboard. From this, each students are sitting, and he's delivering the classes with the use of mic. Is coming to the students by vehicle. The vehicle consists of the speaker, and he's having the audio systems. Wherever you can go with audio system. He's giving the lecture to the school students. That is called individuality. That is called innovations. Even we are thinking about to go for online teaching only, but he's thinking that online teaching is not good for the school students. Particularly the students, particularly the rural areas, to not having the internet connection. Therefore, he find that unique way. The solution, how we can teach these students in this kind of rural settings. That's why he made some kind of innovative idea. So we have to appreciate that kind of thing. This is called as innovative practices. But while doing research, for example, the same issues you are facing, you can suggest the government, these are the method we can adopt for going for online teachings. So that kind of originality thoughts, it can come from your end. That originality work, you can be replicated, you can be showcased in your research report also. Then finally, the main thing is a plagiarism. Plagiarism. So what is a plagiarism represent? Even I wrote the 10 years before one article. The same article, if you publish it, it's called self-plagiarism. We don't use the same article for twice for the book. Suppose I am using the Surya's assignment work. I'm removing the first page of here, I'm writing my name and publishing. It's totally a plagiarism. So you may hear that some of the VC, Vice Chancellor of some university, after getting the Vice Chancellor post, there is a case, then the government, the Supreme Court tell them to resign their job because of the plagiarism. What they did, so the previously that some of the youngsters, elder, what they did in the sense, they are copying one's work and they are duplicate that work of the some books they published in their own names, his names itself. So that kind of plagiarism we have to stop, particularly the context of the research work, what the people are doing. For example, I'm telling the in what manner the research was going on the MET side. For example, last year some students are doing some research work in some area, for example, environmental awareness or the e-waste management. If you look onto that particular topic, the 4 years, the same topic, the same topics, the same, but only the area may change. So somewhat it's copying only. Instead of we can find the novel topic, it's need for an hour for this current scenario. Like that you can think, instead of that, some people's having the confidence, they may come and approach me sometimes, sir, I'm doing this research. I'm asking the why you're starting this research. They may tell, sir, I'm having the one dissertation related to this topic. If I'm having this topic, if I'm going this topic, it may helping me to go through, I'm going for the same manner of the previous topic, which I'm having this report. It's not too fair. Okay, so it's better to be find a innovative topic or a needful topic for the current scenario. You can select the topics in the current situation. Then you can do the research. Instead of that, if you look onto some of the library, always they're doing the environmental awareness for all this 10 years. Even the same guide may be a guide. One of the things they may change, today they may do the Kannur district, tomorrow, the next year they may do the Kasaragod district, the next year they may do the Calicut district. Like that they change the district only, but the tools are same, the way of writing same, only the data little change in the 4-chapter one. So this also some kind of plagiarism. So be cautious, don't be copying the other's work. Your work should be unique in the sense, while seeing your topic itself, the people may have, oh, it's a very novel area, no? So like that they may get that kind of ambience while reading your topic itself. So plagiarism is an act of pausing of somebody else's ideas, thoughts, pictures, theories, words and stories as your work. So this is called as in plagiarisms. Yes, so these are the things it may focusing with me, you can be followed while doing your research work. I request the youngest scholars of the MET scholars, kindly keep it the accuracy, integrity, confidential, transparency, honesty, protecting, authenticity, originality, and plagiarisms. Plagiarism means stop plagiarism. So don't use the plagiarism in your research work. So these are the things we have to strictly follow while doing research. You may do a quantitative research or qualitative research, it is your wish, but you should be go with this much of ethical practices. Otherwise, it should not be fair in the context of the research. So, I request you all to keep this research, this kind of things in a proper manner. Even we meet in this only small thing, but for while doing the research, we cannot be keeping very strict in the research ethics. That's why I request all the research scholars, those who want to do a PhD in the future, kindly stick on to the research ethics properly. So this is my suggestion too. So these questions may come for the big questions. Hopefully, be ready to write the answers. Okay, all the best to all of you. I hopefully maybe you may get some input from the lecture. Thank you, Jaybar.